Hello dear students, today we are going to perform the isolation of pure culture using multiple streak plate method. So the aim of today's practical is to perform isolation of pure culture of microorganisms using multiple streak plate method. And the requirements for this are, that is the bacterial culture E. coli. Chemicals used are peptone, beef extract, sodium chloride, agar, alcohol. Apparatus used is petri plate, conical flask, beaker, test tube, microwire loop, glass marker. And the equipment required is autoclave and incubator. So basically this streak plate technique is a isolation technique, which is one of the isolation technique which is used for the isolation of the microorganisms. So microorganisms, they are found in nature in the form of mixed population, and that is the reason why this isolation technique play a major role in this part. If you want a specific microorganism, that can be obtained by this isolation techniques. So to study the specific role played by specific microorganism, one must isolate the same in pure culture. So two major steps of obtaining a pure culture are, that is, you can dilute the culture on agar surface, that after incubation they form visible colonies, and secondly, after the isolated colony have been obtained, it has to be aseptically picked off onto the isolation plate and then incubated. So two types of culture are there: mixed culture, that is a culture which contains more than one species, and second is the pure culture, that is a culture which contains only one species of microbes. So the isolation technique, it is used to remove the, what you can say, microorganism or the desired microorganism from the mixed culture and then transfer it to the pure culture. So common methods of isolation are what? The process of screening a pure culture by separating it from a mixture is called isolation. And some common methods of isolation are streak plate method, pore plate method, in which loop dilution method and serial dilution technique is used, then spread plate method, micro manipulator method, and rolled loop method. In this practical, we are going to see the streak plate method. So streak plate method, it is the most widely used technique for the isolation of the culture, and it is prepared by streaking a small amount of mixed culture over the surface of solid agar using nichrome wire loop. The sample is streaked in such a way that as you go on streaking it on the agar surface, you will get a diluted sample, and in the end you will get the isolated colonies. So the purpose of streaking out is to thin out the inoculum successively so that the microbes get separated. So pure cultures can be obtained by picking well isolated colonies and restreaking these colonies on the fresh agar plate. So once you get the isolated colony, pick that colony and subculture it on the fresh agar plate. In the beginning of the streak, the microbes are crowded, and as the streaking proceeds, the crowding becomes less, and hence in the last streak, few clearly separated colonies will be observed. Then transfer this well isolated colonies from the streak plate to another new plate for isolation and purification of the desired bacteria. So there are many different types of methods used for the streaking, and out of these, a three sector or T streak and four quadrant streak are the most commonly used methods. And in this practical, we are going to see both these methods. So this is the image of the strict plate method, that is four quadrant strict plate method. So this is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and the fourth. And here you can see there is a heavy growth, and slowly, slowly the growth is decreasing, and in the end you will get the isolated polymers. Significance of strict plate method, that is, it is the most popular method used for the isolation. It is used to grow bacteria on a growth media surface so that individual bacterial colonies can be easily isolated and sampled. Then samples can then be taken and can be grown on a new plate, so it makes it beneficial, and thus the microorganism can be identified, studied, or tested. When the bacteria are streaked and isolated, you can also identify the causative agent of bacterial disease. Limitations of strict plate method. It has two major disadvantages. That is, you cannot grow the obligate anaerobes using this method. And secondly, only organisms that are viable in the original sample are able to grow. So now we will see how to perform the strict plate method. Hello dear students, now we are going to perform isolation of pure culture of microorganisms by using multiple strict plate method. Now this strict plate method, it is an isolation technique. In addition to core plate technique and spread plate technique, strict plate technique is also one of the technique which is used for the isolation of bacteria from the mixed culture. And various kind of strict plate technique is used, like T strict technique and four quadrant strict plate technique. What is this? We will come to know in the procedure. Okay. So we will see the procedure. The very first step is you have to take a sterile Petri plate, and then you have to label the Petri plate with the direction of streaking, and also you have to label it with the quadrants. Then the second step is you have to prepare the agar plate, that is pour the agar in the Petri plate and allow it to solidify. Then you have to perform the inoculation procedure. Now in inoculation procedure, first you will sterilize the nichrome wire loop. Then take the bacterial sample and then streak it as per marking on the plate. Okay, now how the streaking should be done? Two types of streaking you have to do in this. That is the T streak. Now T streak, it is done in the form of T shape. So you have to mark it likewise on the Petri plate before adding the agar. Okay, so it is in the form of T shape. So this type of streaking is known as T streak technique. The second type of streaking, that is the multiple streak, here you can see your four quadrant streaking. In this you have to do streaking in four quadrants. Okay, so this is the first quadrant, then this is the second, this is the third type of streaking, this is the fourth, and from here the end. Okay, so this here, likewise you have to mark it on the plate, and likewise you have to do the streaking. Now care should be taken that once you have taken the bacterial sample on the microwire loop, only that sample you have to streak out throughout the plate, whether it is T streak or the four quadrant streak. Okay,
Not you should not take repeatedly the bacterial sample for streaking the one quadrant, then second, then third, then fourth. Okay, so this should not be done. Okay, now what is the reason that you have to take the bacterial sample only once? Because as you go on streaking successively through the quadrants, first the concentration of the bacteria will be more. Then as you move forward successively through the quadrants, it will thin out. Okay, so when you will incubate it, you will get crowded colonies here, comparatively less crowded colonies here, comparatively less crowded colonies here, and likewise in the fourth quadrant you will get the lesser number of colonies, and in the end you will get the isolated colonies of the bacteria. So that is the reason why you have to take the bacterial sample only once and just streak it out in the fourth quadrant and likewise. Okay, similarly here also you have to take the bacterial sample only once, streak it likewise, and then streak it a zigzag manner. So that is the major step in the streak plate technique, that is the streaking. After streaking, you have to close the plate and then incubate it for 24 hours at 36 degrees Celsius. Now we will see how to perform streak plate technique. First of all, we will see the requirements. That is, the requirements are, this is the nutrient agar which we have sterilized. Then petri plates which are also sterilized by autoclave. This is the bacterial culture of E. coli. Then marker and microwire loop. The very first step while performing the practical is to sterilize the platform. So now this is the platform where I am going to perform the practical. So first of all, I have thoroughly cleaned the platform, here you can see. And now I will disinfect it using the alcohol. So here you can see I have used the ethanol. So I will take a small portion of the cotton and then I will take ethanol and disinfect the platform where I have to perform the practical. Make sure your burners are off while performing this disinfection process, otherwise the alcohol can catch the fire. So just clean the platform properly and allow the alcohol to evaporate. Now here you can see the alcohol has vaporized and this section is completely sterilized. Now we will need to maintain the sterilized air, that is the air environment should be sterilized. So for that I will switch on the burners. And now I will perform the practical in between these two burners. So whatever my requirements are, or if you require taste, I will place in between these two burners. So complete sterile environment will be maintained in between these two burners, and then I will perform the practical here. Now after disinfection, we will then first prepare the plate. So for the preparation of the plate, I have unwrapped the sterilized plate, and now I will mark this with the streaks as I have shown you in the previous video. So I will just mark it So likewise here you can see I have streaked it. This is the first quadrant, this is the second quadrant, this is the fourth quadrant, third quadrant, and this is the fourth quadrant, and then I have streaked it in a zigzag manner. Now this is the second plate in which I have done T streaking, okay, as I have told you while explanation. So now my two plates are ready. First is the fourth quadrant streak and the second is the T streak. Now we will prepare the agar plates. So we will first pour the agar. So this is agar which is cooled to room temperature. I will remove the cotton, flame the neck of the flask, and then I will pour it. Again, I will flame the neck of the flask. And now I will place this plate and allow to solidify. Similarly, I will take this second plate. Flame the neck of the flask and now I will pour it. So now I will place these plates and allow them to solidify. Now we will perform the streaking. So first of all, I will sterilize the nichrome wire loop and I will take this bacterial sample, flame the neck of the culture tube. I will first perform the four quadrant streaking. So I will place this plate in such a way or hold this plate in such a way that the first quadrant will be opposite to my hand. Okay. So when I will open it, I will get the first quadrant opposite and it will be easy for the streaking. Okay. So now I am opening this plate and I will streak it slowly on this agar. I will close this plate, rotate it. Please make sure you don't have to take every time the bacterial culture while streaking. Again, I will rotate it. Now I am doing the streaking in the third quadrant or third phase, you can say. And now this is the last quadrant. And then I am streaking it in a zigzag. Now I have done the four quadrant streaking And as I have discussed earlier, as you go on streaking, the concentration of the bacteria will go on decreasing, and in the end you will get the isolated colonies. That is, the bacterial culture will thin out as you proceed for the further quadrants, and that is the reason why you don't have to take the bacterial culture every time while streaking. Once you have taken the bacterial culture, just take it once and streak it through the four quadrants. So as it will move through the four quadrants, it will thin out, and in the end, in the zigzag section, you will get the isolated colonies. Now I will perform the T streaking. For this, again I will sterilize my nichrome wire loop. This is the bacterial culture which I have. Flame the neck. Flaming is very important to avoid the bacterial contamination. Again, flame it. Now I will take the second plate, and this is quite easy because this is just a T streak. So I will open the plate. Slowly I will streak it on the surface of the agar, and I will move this in zigzag. Now I will place these plates in the incubator. Now I have set the temperature to 35 degrees Celsius, which is the suitable temperature. And now I will place these plates in the incubator. As discussed earlier, you just have to slide the plates so that they will not open, otherwise the contamination from the air can enter. So now we have placed the plates for incubation, and then we will observe the colonies.
So we have already seen the procedure for the streak plate method. So we will just overlook on this. So first, sterilize the inoculating loop. Allow it to cool. Then insert your loop in the tube or culture bottle and spread it over the first quadrant using close parallel streaks. Then immediately streak the inoculating loop very gently over the quarter of the plate using a back and forth motion. Then after streaking it into the first area, go to the edge of the area 1, extend the streak into the second quarter of the plate. Similarly, you have to take the edge of the second area and streak it in the third quarter, and in the end you have to streak it in the center fourth of the plate, and after the end of the fourth quadrant you have to streak it in the last section in the zigzag manner. So here you can see the procedure. This is the first, then this is the second quadrant, this is the third quadrant, and this is the fourth quadrant, and in the end of the fourth quadrant you have to do the, this is the streaking. Okay, so likewise you have to perform the streaking. Okay, now here, as I have already told, that you don't have to take the bacterial culture again and again for the streaking. Only once you have to take the bacterial culture and then streak it. In between, you can do the flaming of your nichrome wire loop if you want. That is optional. That is, you can just after you have done the first streaking, you can just flame or you can just heat the nitrowire loop until it is red hot. Allow it to cool and just streak it. No need to take the sample. So you can go for that technique also, or you can go for the without heating also, you can go for the streaking. Okay, so this is the four quadrant streaking method. Then next streaking that we have performed, that is the T streak method. So it is also known as three phase streaking pattern. The streaking is done using inoculating loop. So the inoculating loop is first sterilized and then it is dipped in the inoculum and then it is dragged across the surface of the agar back and forth to cover approximately 30% of the agar plate area. And then the loop is re-sterilized and the plate is turned to 90 degrees as I have shown in the video. And starting in the previously streaked section, you have to drag that loop 2 to 3 times continuously in the zigzag pattern. So the streak will be formed in the form of a T. So this is the observation of our streaking. So here you can see, here you are getting the isolated colonies, and this is the T streak you can see in that form of a T. Also, there is another technique of T streaking, that is you can just take the agar plate and make a T in between, and then you can streak it in various sections. So that is also one of the way of T streaking. So that is also known as the three quadrant streaking. That is, instead of four quadrants, you will get the three quadrants. That is, just draw the T and streak it out in the three sections. Okay, so that is also one of the technique of T streaking. So observation will be what? Well-developed isolated colonies were observed in the fourth zone. Here you can write down. In case of T-streak, you have to just write well-developed isolated colonies were observed. So the result is the isolation of the pure culture of microorganisms was performed using multiple streak plate method. So the possible questions asked for this practical is, what do you mean by isolation of pure culture, and enlist different methods used for isolation of microorganisms? Then what is the principle of streak plate technique? Write advantages and disadvantages of streak plate technique. Explain the significance of streak plate technique. What do you mean by pure and mixed culture? Explain four quadrant streaking and T streaking. That is how to perform the four quadrant streaking and the T streaking. This you can explain with the help of suitable diagram. So this was all about multiple streak plate method. Thank you students for listening.